How's it going, troops? Jordan here, back again with some more Black Ops 3 beta footage for you guys, courtesy of my good friend Good Helvetica. A link to his Twitter and YouTube channel will be in the description below. Definitely go follow him on Twitter and also subscribe to his channel. He does a lot of concept videos and ideas for Call of Duty games, which are quite good. So I definitely would check him out and also tell him that Jordan sent you. But today's video, we're going to be talking about the attachments in Black Ops 3 and how some attachments have been changed to what we are used to, especially in the older Call of Duty titles. So currently in the Black Ops 3 beta, there are three attachments that have had noticeable changes made to them compared to older Call of Duty games. The first attachment being the adjustable stock. So back in Black Ops 2, we have the adjustable stock attachment for our assault rifles, and it allowed us to move faster whilst we were aiming down our sights. Now, in Black Ops 2, this was really, really useful on assault rifles. It meant that you could aim down your sights constantly and also move as fast as if you had an SMG in your hands. However, in the Black Ops 3 beta, that is not the case. The adjustable stock in the Black Ops 3 beta has been severely nerfed compared to the stock in Black Ops 2. When you equip the stock on your assault rifle, you notice that when you aim down your sights and then you move around, you don't move around nearly as much as you did back in Black Ops 2. Now, personally, I think that this is great because it opens up a lot more variety in terms of attachments on your weapons, and overall I think this is just something that's quite good. Is the adjustable stock a useless attachment now? Of course not. The adjustable stock still makes a difference when you do aim down your sights and move around, it's just that it doesn't grant you a significant mobility increase. Now moving on to the second attachment, being the suppressor. So the suppressor in Black Ops 3 puts you at a disadvantage, especially if you are shooting enemies over long distances. Normally in Call of Duty games, we are used to the silencer doing a little bit less damage over long distances. However, in the Black Ops 3 beta, you can notice this significantly more than before. Now, do I think that this is something great? I'm a bit 50-50 on this one, just because sometimes I do like to run with a suppressor or a silencer because I do like to keep myself a little bit more stealthy than usual, especially in game modes like Search and Destroy. Does this put you at a disadvantage though? It does if you're trying to get enemies over long distances, but it's still pretty decent when you shoot enemies up close. So, is the attachment useless? Obviously not, but it does put you at a disadvantage when firing at targets over range. And finally, the third attachment that has had noticeable changes to it is the foregrip. So back in Black Ops 2, the foregrip wasn't really that useful on assault rifles. You can definitely tell that they were a little bit useful, but they weren't really that useful at all. They were more useless, and you can put that point towards something else like a suppressor or a reflex sight. Well, in the Black Ops 3 beta, the foregrip is actually more useful now. So for example, if you're using an assault rifle or a light machine gun that has heavy recoil to it, if you equip the foregrip, you will notice a significant increase in accuracy. So using the foregrip now is a lot more useful. Is it useful over other attachments? Probably not, but it is quite useful now than it was back in Black Ops 2, which is nice, like I said, if you are using a high recoil light machine gun, or if you're using a high recoil assault rifle. So there we go, troops, three attachments in the Black Ops 3 beta that have had changes made to them, whether it be for the better or for the worst. So let me know your thoughts on these attachment changes in the comment section below. If you did enjoy this Black Ops 3 video, then do give the video a thumbs up, I would appreciate it a lot. And if you haven't subscribed, make sure to do so for all your FPS content, including Black Ops 3. And until next video, I thank you all for watching, stay true to me, troops, and I'll see you in game.